Hi everyone, this is John Dickinson from motionworks.net, back with another Sapphire tip for you. Sapphire includes a pretty powerful lens flare effect, which has its own built-in flare designer. Now I've applied lens flare to this solid layer. If I click on Edit Lens, that's going to open up the flare designer. You can see I can click and drag around to move that flare around. And if I want to, I can delete all of these layers just by clicking on the trash can, and I can build a flare from scratch. And I can do that by adding objects, such as this blob. And I can come over to the properties column on the right here, and I can adjust that. Maybe change the color, just build something quick here. Change the size, add another one, and make that a little smaller. Something like that. And add some rays. Very, very responsive and super fast to create your own custom looks. If you prefer not to build a flare from scratch, you can use one of the presets as a starting point. Just by clicking on Open Lens, browsing through the presets and choosing one that you like. I'm going to choose this blue starburst. Double click. And that loads that one up. Then I can make some adjustments. I'm going to delete this blue shimmer too. And I want to add some rays. And I'm going to take the number of rays down to 1. Next, I'm going to add a spot. And I'm going to change that to a blue and just adjust the gradient to make that soft, but I want to make this nice and big. Something like that. I can also add some smoky atmosphere to my flare just by using the settings that are under noise. If I increase the noise amount, you can see because I had the spot selected, I'm adding noise to the spot, which is not what I want in this particular case. I want to select this center blue spot and add the noise to that. It's nice to be able to add noise to any of the individual elements. So I'm going to increase the noise amount and increase the noise frequency and the detail. And that adds a really nice smokiness to the flare without needing another effect. Now the mode of our flare is currently set to 2D, but I can also choose 3D mode. And when I do that, you can see the flare disappears. So first of all, I have to add a light to the scene. So I'm going to choose Layer, New, Light. And I'll just keep it at its default settings for now. And you can see as soon as I do that, the flare reappears. Let's just take a quick look at the settings. You can see under hotspots, we have point light 1. And you might have more than one light in your scene. So here you can choose which lights the flare will attach itself to. And if I adjust these light settings, you can see that the settings will also affect the flare. Things like intensity, if I change the color, for example, they both affect the flare. Now, if I drag the Z position, you can see I can adjust that. Also, of course, the X and the Y. And you can also have the flare orbit the scene. I'm going to create a new camera by choosing Layer New Camera. Just a default camera. And I'm going to right click on the camera and choose Camera, Create Orbit Null. And that links my camera to a null object. Now if I rotate that on the Y axis, you can see my flare is orbiting the scene. So as you can see, it's really handy to have 3D as an option to better integrate flares into your 3D scenes. Thanks for watching, and be sure to click on the link in the description to download a free trial of Sapphire for After Effects and check out these great plugins for yourself. Also follow Boris Effects on YouTube, Facebook, and Twitter to stay up to date with the latest information and training materials on Continuum, Sapphire, Mocha Pro, and all of the Boris Effects products.